Ví se název této Gamesis? Yo.
Go! Hello everybody, I'm Jeff Keighley and this is Summer Game Fest, a live showcase of what's next in the wide, wide world of video games. We are live here in Los Angeles, so whether you're streaming from home or watching inside an IMAX
theater, life's hopeless hole called LA.
Over the next few hours, we'll give you updates on the games you love, be joined by special developer guests, and yes, have a few surprises along the way too.
Now,
what I love about this show is that it's a true cross-industry showcase. Whether you play on Xbox, PC, PlayStation, Switch, or mobile,
PC, Xbox,
it doesn't matter your platform of choice.
God of War Ragnarok, teď se někdo připravuje na zklamání, ještě než to začalo, už zase, stejně jako u toho State of Play.
Video games. The biggest franchises in the industry are here, like Call of Duty. You'll get introduced to exciting new worlds, new teams, and we'll make room for small independent developers who we think deserve the spotlight too. If we do this right, hopefully you'll discover a few new games to put on your wish list. And even if you don't get every announcement that you desire, and let's face it, you're not going to get everything today, but we've got a lot of great stuff. So let's get
started. To je ten týpek na koksu. Všichni v tomhle biznesu jsou na koksu, aby zvládli otravný retardy jménem hráči, jako seš ty. And ever since, this legendary Japanese fighting game has continued to
evolve. Street Fighter 6 is coming in 2023. And right now, we're excited to officially confirm a character coming to the game.
Kurva, to neslyším pořádně.
The exclusive first gameplay footage.
Dobrý, to už
bylo. Enjoy.
Gameplay ze Street Fightera, no tak to mě poser, to jsem fakt chtěl vidět. Tomu říkám silný start, něco jako Resident Evil 4 remake. Chat, nechte mě hádat, vlevo bude jeden hráč a vpravo bude druhý hráč a přijdou do prostřed a budou se tam být. Schválně, jestli jsem to trefil. To mě poser. Nepovídej. Geofe, tohle je absolutně úžasné. Reklama na nápoj skoro pím lmal. Co? OK, pleboši, hele, nechám vás puštěný na tuhle konferenci. Normálně to nedělám, protože konference si chci užít a každý rok se těším na E3 a vy jste otravný jak prase, je tady hromada IGN recenzentů a celkově kriplů, který nechápu, proč se vůbec pohybují v gamingu, když očividně ty vole je to nebaví každý rok stejně jako Oscaři nebo filmový průmysl. Jo? Takže nechám vás puštěný, ale ty pičo. Tak, už mi tady všechno naběhnulo. Mám na tady ten ročník bingo. Ukáž. Fortnite, Resident Evil Village, Plague Tale Requiem, Need for Speed, GoldenEye HD. Docela dobrý. Hail to the king, baby. Okay, já si dám tohle to bingo. Já si ho dám na druhý monitor.
All right. Next, it's time for a brand new game announcement here at Summer Game Fest. Check this out.
Check a look. Budeš natáčet Metro 2023? Dobrý, okay. Labs, sorry, jdete si do sub only. Fakt, sorry. Fakt, ale prostě... Nechci mít nádor po každý, co se jenom podívám do toho chatu. Sorry, vydrželi jste to dvě minuty, docela dobrý. Sergeant Leo Alvarez of the CMLeth Recon Squad. Our mission was to enter the Tantalus base, locate the comsat relay, and bring it back. Ty vole, to je alien hra. We found the relay, but there was a problem. To není Kalisto, to je alien podle těch pušek. To jsou pulz rifle. No poslední vetřelčí hra byl ten Fire Squad, ne? Co jsme hráli v koopu, to byla jako docela pěkná sreť, nebo jako to bylo jako tak průměrný, jak to mohlo být. Jestli tohle bude jenom DLC na to, jakože asi jo, protože jsou tři. To bude jenom DLC, že jo? This ain't good. What we found was a new kind of evil. Colonial Marines 2, ty píču, Colonial Marines 2, to bych zabíjel. Co to kurva je? This wasn't human. proč ve Střelce má spolupracovat androidi. Když oni byli androidi vlastně v tom Fire Squadu. Ale ty byli teda pěkně otravný. Pan za otázku 1984. Ne, on psal specificky ty nejhorší otázky. Když pojď se do jeho chatlogu, on specificky psal jenom hovna absolutně unrelated k tomu, co se děje na obrazovce. Now everyone's dead. Devolver je o půlnoci. Aliens Dark Descent? Že to je úplně jináčí hra? A jasně, já jsem si říkal, ty vole, že to nevypadá na AAA věc. Že to bude pohled z vrchu, anebo to bude Fire Squad DLC. Shit. Kámo, já to nechápu. Oni během dvou let podějí další dvě Alien hry průměrný. A neudělají tu Isolation 2 po 7 letech, i když to doslova každý chce. Proč odklepnou každou Alien hru, kromě té Isolation 2? Quote unquote Schofield cut of the brand new trailer with a little more gore. Oh shit, Schofield cut Callisto Protocol traileru, který má být víc brutální než ten předchozí, to jde? Je tak Relus tak brzy, běží tady konference jenom, kdyby si nahoru viděl. Levoši, tenkej let, chlapci. Take a look outside. Did you know that they call Callisto the dead moon? Dead. Just like you would have been if I hadn't fished you out of that wreck. Vím samý trailer, co jsme viděli, ale má tady být extra gore, nějaký bonusový záběry. That's your old life. You gotta let that go. Because your new life is entirely in my hands. To byla jaká parádička na prosinec. I'm just trying to give you a chance at rebirth. Ještě aby to ideálně, potvrdili ten God of War na listopad. I just love that last part. God of Waru se šušká odklad. No tam je to posunutý na kvartál 4, což sedí, protože kvartál 3 bude ten Last of Us remake. Pičo, ale ovšem tohle je extended gameplay, baby. To zase nevypadá až tak dobře. To je trailer, to je, že neumí udělat trailer, to je celý. To gameplayově. Do píči! Welcome to your new home. Kurva, doufám, že tohle neodsunou, tohle je perfektní vánoční hra. Jste právě fakt dobře, to mě dostane do té krásné toho, do té náladičky. Jasně, Digital Deluxe, to už je taková klasika. Steam Epic, to je velice sympatické. LOL prvák. That's right, solíku. We know what you wanted to see. And joining me now, Glenn Schofield, Striking Distance. Glenn, first of all, congratulations. This game looks absolutely incredible. Ty byla nejlepší, že měsíc po tomhle má být remake Dead Spaceu. Takže vlastně budeme mít dva vesmírný mega brutální horory. Yeah, thanks, man. Thanks for having us. I really do appreciate it. To je jako celkem maraz. And you know, for a second, just give me a second. You know, I want to thank you for all you've done for the game industry all these years, man. I think I've known you like 16, 17 years now. And you've been an ambassador. You've amplified new games, new studios. Každopádně, máme první chat. I just wanted to thank you. Počkej moment, já si musím odevřít v malování.
It's not about me, it's about you guys.
Yeah, I know, but
I appreciate that. Thank you so much. And yeah, it's so fun to do these shows and to show this game. So people saw the trailer, but what I'm so excited today is that you just brought a raw gameplay sequence. This game is in development and people are going to be blown away, I think, when they see it. But tell us a bit about what are we going to see today?
Yeah, we got a couple minutes of, like you said, like raw gameplay. It's two segments in the first half of the game. One is a med bay, another one is a power station, and you're going to see
Kalisto, some
new enemies, some brutality, some just about everything. We're showcasing a new weapon called the Grip. It's like a gravity gun, but it picks up the enemies, and it shoves them into giant fans. It rips them apart. It's great. And then check out the nice ending we have, where we, you know, we usually will kill our main character, Jacob, in a very unique way.
And just for a second, I want to thank the team, man.
Like you said, through COVID, through everything else, the dedication, the hard work, you guys are amazing.
Wow, this is a brief gaming.
Well, Glenn, I got to say, again, you know, what you guys are shipping this year, this looks like a world-class next-gen
game.
It's rare that teams are bringing something out like this year, and let's let the footage speak for itself. Ben Schofield, Striking Distance. Here it is, the first gameplay of the Callisto Protocol.
Oof.
Hail to the king, baby.
Oof. Stávka DJU, je. Má to takový divný motion blur efekt, že to je při pohybu, to je takový docela mázlý. Probudil se jim tady Cray pacient. To je Sebastian Force bez jednoho dne. Mad Monku. Action is coming. On tam má normálně to jako psychicení a odhazování, jo. Si fakt ty vole, od toho Dead Spaceu vzali co mohli. On zase na druhou stranu, když tu Dead Space 4 udělat prostě to EA nechce. Tak co máš kurva dělat? APčka má vzadu na krku, ne na páteři, víš co, oni si řekli, uděláme Dead Space, ale uděláme takový ty minimální změny, aby nás nemohli zažalovat. Budeš je rozdupávat, budeš jim ustřelovat končetiny. Budeš mít HPčka ne na páteři, ale okolo krků. Munici budeš mít taky na zbrani. Ten Glenn, co tam byl, je původní vývojář Dead Space, no to chápu, ale jako, že že už nemáš tu značku, tak to uděláš, ale vlastně tam jako zatím nedáš zase úplně tolik novýho. Může pak jako vypadat trošku jako ten, no, vykrádání sebe sama. Sranda bude samozřejmě v tom, že měsíc po tomhle právě vychází ten remake toho prvního Dead Space. Schválně. Takže když už nebude otec té série makat na tom remakeu, tak bude zajímavý pozorovat, co bude lepší. Ale ty FPS jim teda padají brutálně.
Oh my god. That just happened. All right, moving on. This October, Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2 arrives. Infinity Ward is once again returning to its roots for a modern-day action game.
Ale od těch vývojářů hezký, že poprosili Czech Clouda, tím nahraje gameplay, ať to vypadá dobře.
To tell us more, let's head to the port of Long Beach to check in with Johanna Ferris, the head of Call of Duty.
Zase mi to nepomáčil v obrovský balč. Má, on je nadržený ze všech těch revealů, který konečně může ukázat světu.
October 28th, we usher in a new era of Call of Duty with the launch of Modern Warfare 2.
We are kurva, doufám, že bude dobrý můťák. Hnedka při startu, ať si zahraju.
Price, Gaz, Soap, Alejandro, and of course, Ghost. We needed a stage big enough to debut Call
Ghost!
Of Duty.
Ghost! No! Shepard!
Inspired by the world we're about to enter. Oil rigs, cargo ships, and staggering odds are just the beginning. Here is Modern Warfare 2.
Let's go! Dark Water. Aha, takže se jede... No jistě, Oil Rig level ze dvojky. Je to remake nebo ne? To je soft remake. Přijet pod vodou byl víc cool. Jo no, jako jo, když jsi jel pod tou vodou a vylodil se stivě ze spoda pomocí těch ponorek, tak to bylo víc cool. Tohle je 2013 grafika. Tohle je 2013? Tohle je 2013, že jel Killzone Shadowfall. Tak jako Modern Warfare 2019 bylo dobrý graficky imho v tom Killhouse a ve všem. Jako oni to samozřejmě vydají i na tou starou generaci konzolí, takže samozřejmě, že to budeš moct hrát na svý PS4 Slimce, ale ty vole, fakt bych to úplně moc jako nedoporučil. Rim clear, coming out. Battlefield 2042 vypadá mnohem líp. No, tak já si myslím, že jakoby těch 500 hráčů, co to teďko hraje, si to musí užít, no. Tyvo, ale jako Vektor s tlumičem, to zase bude prasárna v mulťáku. On nepřebíjí po každém výstřelu. Ne, asi to mě úplně sere jako kod hráče. Roger dostal vody váno. Já myslím, že se bude válčit s kartelem. Jsem neviděl, jestli kartel že vlastní i plošiny. Kde v Modern Warfare sérii? Ve dvojce konkrétně se válčil s... Já teda si pamatuju Makarova a nějaký ruský letiště, ale jako... Už to ukazují na konzoli. To je to zaměřování, to je vždycky takový, aby to bylo víc cinematic. Byla tam favela v Brazílii, no, to je pravda. Ty jsou super, no. A tak ty vole. To je to i na 7 let staré konzoli, smiley face. Tak samozřejmě, když PS5 se prodalo teprve 20 milionů a PS4 je asi 150, 140, 120 milionů, tak ty vole, hry čistě jako na PS5 budou až tak 2024, že jo. Kdy už i ta PS5 bude hardwareově zase pozadu oproti PCčkám. Si bohužel, no, nestíhají vyrábět. Nechtějí vyrábět, ale chtějí prodávat prostě hry pro 100 milionů hráčů, no, jako bohužel je to... Je to jaký to je? Mohli by pak vydat PS5 proučko někde 2025, to by bylo docela nice. Ví se název této Gamesy? Takže zase konzole kurví hry? Ne, kdyby nebylo konzole, tak tadyhle ta hra vůbec nebude a nebude ani tak 90% her, co jsou tady ukázaný. Víš proč? Protože by byly jenom na PC. Víš, co by to znamenalo? Že by všechny kopie byly ukradený, pro nikdo si nekupuje hry na PC. Takže... Jo, jasně, ty konzole jsou jako technologicky pozadu. Výhoda je, že je mají gigantický množství lidí. To už není pravda. Dobrý, Lefexátor, tak mi ukáž, kolik procent prodejů u AAA her mají PC, má PC platforma. Yep.
Take the ramp! Hold tight, Sergeant!
Let's have ourselves a gunfight!
Missile patrols are on the bridge! Have to stop the launch!
Teď se bojí bakon a teď se bude tyko, tyko zaměřováčů granátů, jako v Modern Warfare 2 19. To se mi líbí. Dobrý, je to nový Crysis, nebo co to je? Crysis bez nanosuitů, ty vole, proč ne? Reloading! Se herní chyby, nabiješ na první pokus správně a hlaveň dává nahoru. Počkej, ty mi jako chci říct, že člověk elitních jednotek nenabije na první pokus. Plus herní se napsal s Y-onem na konci. Hele, boys, jako ty píčo, já jsem tady 10 minut, ale ty vole, normálně bych radši dal 20 minut toho TV Twix, protože tohle je fakt masakr, co předvádíte. Tohle je neuvěřitelný. Já to mrdám. Tak to já... Uf. Jak to dělají ty streameři, co mají odpolední slot? Já je fakt obdivuju. Tenhle ten gameplay nevypadal tak dobře jako ta Modern Warfare 2019.
That's what we're talking about. And joining us now, up from Long Beach, Johanna, great to see you. How's everything?
It's great. Thanks.
Great to have you with us. And also Jeff from Infinity Ward. So we saw the first gameplay. Thanks for that extended sequence. Looks incredible. Jeff, tell us a bit about that mission. Where is that set in the game? What are we seeing there?
Absolutely. So first of all, we're really excited to welcome back Captain John Price and Gaz Garrick. You know, they're not actually in what we just saw today, but they're returning members from 141. And then the other two characters that were you may recognize from the older franchise that we're reimagining are Simon Ghost Riley and, of course, Soap John McTavish. And then a couple other new characters in here that we're really excited that we got to create for this game. First, Commander Philip Graves, and Mexican Special Forces Colonel Alejandro. I gotta say, we're really excited about. He's a guy who's super capable and a guy who's just as important as Task Force 141.
As far as the levels concerned,
I gotta shout out to IW. You know, this was a tremendous collaboration across all of the different disciplines. As you saw, everybody coming together, some really motivated devs here, and you know, you saw the wind and the animations and the awesome sound design, and of course our new water tech, which is actually pushing the boat in different directions.
It's creating a physically dynamic environment, definitivně allowing for the cover you were seeing in certain cases to be behind cover, and then suddenly that cover would shift and leave you exposed. Also, there's the enemy exposed, creating some emergent gameplay.
So again, I'm very excited, just can't wait, that I'm so excited that we get to show it off today.
And that's just a hint of where things
are going to go. Potom lesom šel zpívat na post-hardcore koncík. Ne, to je, ty vole, tenhle zaskakuje za toho, 21 Pilots.
Yeah, we, first of all, thanks for having us here. We're just so excited for October 28th. It's such a big moment, not just for Modern Warfare 2, and everything that Jeff and the team at Infinity Ward have built, but it really marks the step change, what we're calling a transformational moment for the entire franchise. You're going to see incredible rendering, incredible graphics, all the things just within the game itself, built all on one shared engine now across Warzone and Modern Warfare 2 going forward. Of course, there's a lot of chatter and interest about the new Warzone experience. We're affectionately calling it Warzone 2.0. There will be a standalone experience of Warzone for current existing players as well. So we're going to sort of feed the entire community there. But all eyes on the 28th. And again, I think the collaboration's just been incredible. Everybody's so excited for Task Force 141. Warzone coming to mobile as well for players on the go. We're on Steam, as you know. I mean, so it's just a big moment.
Hru, nebo jdeme na slepo. Ne, já jsem jenom čekal na ten countdown. Já se jenom prostě těším na tu konferenci. Mě nezajímá ta konference. Já miluju ten hype. Já se rád těším na to těšení.
Yeah, when we're seeing that from the community, we love when the fans.
Myslíš, že představí a všetko, co máš v tom zozname?
Maybe seeing high rise and other elements, but we will get into the details of Warzone 2.0 for sure. It will be an extension of the Modern Warfare.
Hele, tohle už je druhý Slovák, co se mě ptá na bingo. Hej, podle mě Slovensko nikdy nepoznalo bingo. Podle mě to tam prostě nedorazilo, ten koncept. Dorazili tam třeba šachy. Hej, Slováci, znáte bingo? Nebo se to u vás jmenuje jinak? Nebo se to třeba hraje na jinakým poli, třeba trojúhelníkovým nebo něco, nebo jakoby, abych věděl.
And now it's time to announce a classic PC gaming franchise is coming back with a sequel over 30 years after its first release. I loved this game when I was growing up, so I'm honored to share this very first look.
Und cítil něco. Jakou divoplivu si za 400 korun českých, ty absolutní mada a lade. Bingo hráme pri čakání na brinzové halušky.
Já poznám iba bongo, čuje bongo nevím a som kulelis.
Flashback 2, on byl Flashback 1.
All right, let's turn back time. Back in 2017, we announced Witchfire at the Game Awards.
Co to můžeš sám? Včera hraješ Rus SK. Včera hraješ jednu Rus SK titulkama.
Put together an in-depth look at the gameplay of this dark fantasy first-person shooter, which will enter early access soon. I am so excited to play this, and I bet you will be too after you see this.
Ty vole, Witchfire. To jsem myslel, že nikdy nevznikne. Že to regulérně, že to prostě smazali. Ten dostal dobrou bídu. Tohle je Bioshock ze světa Zaklínače. Jako odhle tý hudby, to feeluju, no. Čo má takový divný hejbání těch zbraní zleva doprava. Dva, ale borci se moc nechytají teda. Jsem zvolá ještě ani jeden, nepřiblížil k tomu hlavnímu hrdinovi, ten je tady absolutně chropý. Tady ty zbraně, jako, oh ty píčo, opakovačka v FPSku, OMG. A revolver k tomu, já prohraju. Dobrý, ještě mi ukáž nějakou dobrou dvouhlavňovku, prosím. Early Access již brzy, no tak ty vole, tak mi to nakonec vydaj. Ale pouze na Epiku. Jo, proč ne, ty vole, jako first person střílečky,
okay,
mám rád.
Okay, next up comes an ambitious new game from a new independent studio in Europe, starring some very familiar names. Enjoy this world premiere new game announcement.
Světová giga premiéra.
Je ta Plzeň, prosím vás, studená?
Čo tam po bingu? Já se těším, ako ti zase naši bratři a sestry nebudou rozumět poslo...
Today, I can't believe what I saw.
Solace, everything okay in there?
Chat, proč píšete Starfield, když doslova psal, že to je od indie studia? Bethesda je jako indie studio, jo? Something's wrong, I can feel... Fort Solis. Troy Baker, oh my god! Je to můj oblíbený dubber Troy Baker.
That's something
to jistě. Troy Baker klasicky slyšel, že je hra, kde by mohl dubovat.
Oh
můj bože, Roger Clark. Teďko musí říct, Arthur, my boy, Troy, já mám plán.
Who are your characters in this game?
Well, I get to play a character named
Troy Nemluv, nech Roger mluvit.
Stationed at this base Fort Solis. And it's the epicenter of this mystery that we'll discover and uncover as we go through the game, and of course my character will be at times in opposition with Roger's character.
The battle we've been waiting to see.
Yeah. Oh man, we can't wait to show you what we've been working on. And by the way, Jeff, this looks awesome, man.
Yeah,
it's so great to be here. Thanks for having us.
It's so great that you're in another game. It's feeling like this is your first game since.
It's
one of the first major ones for a while. And I play a character by the name of Jack Leary. He's a maintenance engineer on a remote Martian mining post.
Okay.
His job is to make sure that none of the equipment breaks down while it's on their graveyard shift. The graveyard shift meaning Mars and Earth are really far apart from each other and their orbits around the sun. So help is not a simple call away.
Ty vole, to mě poser. Ale já fakt jako ty vole nechci znít jako nějaký Pražák, ale vy jste fakt neskutečný vesničaní, některý z vás, to mě poser. Mně se líbí jak borci, kteří mají 150 kilo a jsou ty vole, už 8 večer nalezli za kompem, jsou z nějakého důvodu módní policie. Jako ještě chápu ty IGN recenzenty, ale módní policie, ty vole. To je, kdybych já začal kritizovat, co to má kurva na sobě. A přitom ty vole, jsem rád, že jsem občas ty vole dolezu v džínách.
But it was also brand new consoles. We had more tools that were being made available that were leveling the playing field between like the AAA studios
Dělám
and the
bingo
studios
do virtuální reality.
And so, just like anybody else, we got reached out, James Tinsdale, with this brand new studio. So we
like
for you
consider being a part of this game.
And he walked me through a very brief description of what the experience was going to be like. And in the very beginning, he said, it's we want this to feel it's a tight thriller.
Jako Fortnite to není, je to Fort Solis.
Meets Duncan Jones.
Takže...
I was like sign me up. I'm into that absolutely.
And full like performance.
Nemám co bych zaškrtnul, kámo.
Absolutely. New studio, brand new energy, and of course I get to work with one of the best of the business.
And me.
I get the privilege of getting to see this guy and watch him in action. I know I love to work and I love
I've
seen some of the behind the scenes and the performance capture Unreal Engine 5. I mean, this is it looks absolutely phenomenal. Can you give us a hint about the gameplay? Like, what are we going to do in this game?
Yeah, the verbs are always important. So we're going to let the game speak for itself. We'll be showing you more later on. But this is a game where you as the player, you're going to be exploring, you're going to be discovering. Like we said, it's a very tight thriller. So you're moving very fast-paced through this world. There'll be multiple locations, multiple ways for you
to
traverse, which we're excited to show you about. And then the narrative is a huge element to this.
Já si to zahraju, protože tam uslyším Artura.
Any resources on the performance for sure. I got to tell one quick story, if I can. It was one of our favorite moments. There is a lot of action in this game, and that was at the forefront of this. And to speak to the performance capture aspect, we brought in an incredible, I gotta give him a shout out, to Nathaniel, our stunt coordinator, who walked us through
and really impressed us in a completely different way than anything I've ever done before. So I want to know the story of this fight. And so Roger and I sat down and said,
these are who our characters are, and
he's
going to give me 1 hour to come back to you with the story of this fight. And after now, he comes to us and he goes, it was like a recovery program. It was 12 steps. And he walked us through this incredible fight. About halfway through, I started tuning him out. And I was like, hey, man, I just want to let you know, I've got no ego about this, but I can do a lot of things, but I can't do this. And he grabbed me by my shoulders and he says, oh, you can, you will, and it's going to be glorious.
And we did.
And we did.
It's like a dance. There was a lot of trust, and it worked out.
Yeah, I mean,
we're excited about it.
Big stunts. I mean, this is so cool to see.
Holy moly, Mick Gordon soundtrack, let's go! Konečně něco dobrýho. Dělej, ukáž mi ten Atomic Heart. Serte na rusáky, prostě to vydejte pro zbytek světa, my to koupíme. Kurva, to ale nevypadá moc jako Atomic Heart, bratře. Do prdele ten pohyb, ty vole. Tak Alien Isolation, kámo. Regulérně, fakt jako to, jak se hejbe. Když volí na Isolation. Routine. Unaware. Jo, to je Lunaware software.
Doesn't that look great? That
was promiká je dělání tadyhle toho soundtracku, pouze běžná rutina, chápete?
And is now officially back. I can't wait to see more. Now it's time to check
in
with
na Game Passu rovnou. Vypadá dobře, ty vole, každá další hororovka vypadá sweet. Dej mi víc.
Fortnite as the foundation. Dwayne Johnson, welcome to Summer Game Fest. How are you?
Ne, prosím.
What's up, everybody? And what's up, Jeff? And what is up to the Summer Game Fest.
Jak prostě neměl čas tam dorazit, tak místo toho to točí ve fitku.
And everybody inside the epic IMAX theaters. Dwayne Johnson here coming at you from my Iron Paradise, the very hot and sweaty.
Kámo, hele, říkej si, co chceš, ale jít prostě ze škaredýho dlouhovlasýho wrestlera 20 let zpátky, který neumí hrát, na nejplacenějšího mužského herce. Ty vole, jako sorry, ale to prostě chce grind. Jich tam regulárně dropnu ještě svůj... On tam dropne dvakrát svůj energeťák.
There's always room for the extra large cheese pizza, especially when I'm delivering and I deliver them often. You guys also know me as the greatest and most electrifying.
Proč má to fitko větší než můj byt? Ne, asi. On prostě posiluje na místě, kam by podle mě ty vole se vešlo, tak 5 pražských rodin, ještě by za to zaplatili na společném nájmu tak 100 táců měsíčně.
I gotta say that, you know, I've had such a pleasure working with Epic Games and the teams over there, and we cannot wait to show you what we have in store for the future. And speaking of the future, in the future, you will also know me as Black Adam. Black Adam, as millions of you know around the world who know the Black Adam mythology, he is ruthless, he is unstoppable.
DC film, ja se nemohu dočkat.
Quick tutorial is this. Black Adam has the powers of Superman, but the only difference...
Okay, Roku, teďko zdvihni jedno obočí a podívej se do kamery.
Superman's weakness is magic, and Black Adam's, one of his superpowers, is magic. So you do the math. October 21st. I cannot wait for you guys to see Black Adam around the world in theaters only. And you guys will finally see the hierarchy of power in the DC universe change.
Počkej, chceš mi říct, že jakoby prostě on přišel na Summer Game Fest, aby to vypadalo, že tam mají jako roka, že tam mají celebritu, jenom proto, aby plaknul svůj energeťák a film.
So until then, stay healthy, stay safe, stay focused, keep having fun, keep kicking ass, enjoy your gaming, and I'll see you down the road. This is Black Adam.
Ty vole, no tak to snad ne. Bomba. Hraje tam Kanye West, takže co k tomu mám říct. To byl Jay-Z, pičo. Já bych chtěl říct, že jsou všichni stejný, ale nemůžu. Dva Outriders, no, to byla hra. Jako... Outriders rozhodně byla jedna z her roku 2021. Jako mě ty vole i ten gunplay jako bavil, když jsem tam měl toho teleportujícího píčuse a hrál jsem to s Brokou. Mě to jako i bavilo, ta kampaň. Do endgameu jsem se nedostal. Takže mi to bylo jedno. Mafie 4 trailer. Jo, to víš, jo. Já jsem moc rozhodnutý gunplayem z Destiny, abych si užil Outriders. Avšak Outriders je third person a Destiny je first person střílečka, ne? Tak by to podle mě není úplně jako porovnatelný gunplayově. Nintendo Switch. Splatoon 3 bude tenhle rok, no. Oh my god, nejlepší hra! Mně se líbí, jak to Nintendo prostě ty úplně dominuje, ty všebříčky a pak ukážou ty vole jejich vlajkovou loď a je to prostě japonská hra, která při kombatu běží na 15 FPS a všude lítají čísla s tím šíleným bitratem. Ty kokot, jsem ready na letní Fall Guys maraton. Oh my god, to je ta streamerka, co mi chce prodat krém proti modrýmu světlu z monitoru. Dobré, a kde je Poki?
Hezký večer přeji.
Moje babička může hrát tuhle tu hru. Season 1, oni to resetovali, pojď se season 1. Doufám, že mi zůstane Hotline Miami skin. And you can play and download Fall Guys for free starting June 21st across all platforms including Nintendo Switch, Xbox, PC. Chat, bude tam placený Battle Pass, aby to uživili, takže doufám, že všichni koupíte season 1 s mým support creatorem. Universe from a new team of legendary developers. Check this out. Ne, proč ne, chat? Frost Giant, ty vole, ty dělali co, to znám ten název. A...
Discovery, this is Command. Storm's in your way. Prepare for extraction.
Signal's breaking up. Command, I'll do one last scan. See you soon. Over.
Trailer začíná tu ženskou postavou, je to dobrý chat. Kvalitní videohra hnedka.
Okay, hurry.
Zdá se mi to, alebo sa tie hry graficky vůbec neposúvajú posledných pár rokov. Ty vole, Polanko, to je fakt šokr, ty vole. Když ještě nikdo do píči nemá zasranou PS5 po roce a půl a už když vyšla, tyhle, tak prostě a jednoduše to je konzole za 13 000 korun v době. Ty za 13 000 korun máš možná tak procesor do kompu. To je fakt šokr. Skoro jako kdyby jsme se dostali už do nějakého foto realistického pásma té grafiky a už se nedá úplně dělat takový skoky, jako když ty vole tvoje hra má rozlišení 600 na 400. Bylo to 640 na 400. Píčá, máš pravdu.
Hang tight, Doc. I've got this.
Nebylo to na 480. Však to je dobré. Když nikdo nemá tu 3090, a vyutáhne něco lepšího. Ne, se nevyplatí dělat pro lidi, co mají 3090. Hlavní věc jsou ty konzole, že jo? Musí se posunout konzole, musí je všichni mít, aby nevycházely only hry, pak se to dá teprve to využdímat.
Glad you could make it. We gotta move. Now. There's a storm coming. And hell's coming with it.
Lidský oko rozpozná pouze 69 na 60 rozlišení. Ne, chat. Lidský oko vidí maximálně 69 snímků za sekundu. Větší frame rate je už zbytečný.
There you have it, Tim.
Jedině ten nový Stalker vypadá po piči, hádám. Přesně, Stalker 2 je prostě jediná hra, na kterou má smysl čekat. Abych se jinak vysral na gaming, ale prostě pro toho Stalkera postavím to PC.
What is a Stormgate, though?
All right, so Stormgates are portals that open during a massive solar storm that unleash the infernal host on future Earth.
Okay. And we saw some hints of some race. I mean, you know, you guys coming from Blizzard and StarCraft, everyone wants to know about races. You know, tell us about the sides in this RTS.
Já vím, že to znamená, jenom
když přijde
tvoje máma.
Yeah, we're unveiling our first two factions.
Got him.
There will be more. So the Human Resistance, and we saw an archaeologist from the Human Resistance in that intro cinematic, and then also the Infernal Hosts, who are these demon-like monsters.
Na to měl tenkrát Andrej v levelu dobrý článek. Všechno, co je vyšší než 800 na 600 rozlišení, už oko nepozná, dokud nehraješ na dvoumetrový obrazovce. No tak to je teda ale jako solidní píčovina, co jsi právě napsal. To co je za sračku.
Any sense of what you want to do for the gameplay in this game?
Absolutely. But the first thing I want to say is we are very consciously trying to stay true to what players already love about RTS. Where we're really trying to push the genre and be innovative, first off, approachability. For one thing, we're free to play, but no pay to win, no NFTs, nothing like that. Just to lower that barrier to entry to get players in. But we're also really trying to be a lot more social. So you'll be able to play the campaign cooperatively. We've got three-player open-ended co-op, and we've even got 3v3 for competitive multiplayer. But of course, we've also still got 1v1 competitive.
And as a little surprise, I think we've got some first kind of work-in-progress images from the game, right?
Yeah, these are still very much still being worked on, but some shots of actual assets that we're building in Unreal Engine 5.
Wow, well, I love it. 2023, you said, for the beta, so people can sign up now, get ready. And I'm just so thrilled that there is a brand new RTS franchise coming from you guys and your background and what you did, you know, at Blizzard and StarCraft. We're so excited about this team, Frost Giant. Thank you so much for giving us your announcement today on Summer Game Fest.
Thank you so much for having us here. Really great.
Awesome. All right. Frost Giant, Stormgate, keep an eye out for it. Now it's time for another indie game announcement that I'm excited to share with you. Highwater. Check this one out.
Good morning, Highwater dwellers. Highwater Pirate Radio keeping you in the know with our flow. AlphaVille authorities continue to deny false rumors that AlphaVille elites are planning to evacuate to Mars. True or not, the one thing we can't deny is that the world ended on
a Sunday. Chat, by the way, kdyby náhodou vám přišlo, že tady jsou sami indie píčoviny, tak v neděli je Microsoft Bethesda konference, která už by měla mít ty klasický, velký, AAA, gigadrahý hry. Neboť to je ten samý stage, na kterém byl 3 roky zpátky Keanu Reeves, Big Chungus. Wholesome moment. A určitě oznámějí Wolfensteina 3. Zcela jistě. Překládej do znakové řeči, nebo se vracím na ČT1. Chat! Jediný znakový znamení, který pro vás mám, je tadyhle to. Můžete si to interpretovat, jak chcete. Hello, Highwater. To je jako, že jsme jednotky, přesně tak. Jste moje zlatíčka, všichni do jednoho.
What a breathtaking trailer. Highwater is an adventure strategy
game. Jako breathtaking, potom co jsem zmínil Keanu Reevese. Náhoda.
Nebo
mám celý scénář Summer Game Festu tady vedle sebe, protože mi ho Geoff poslal na Twitter.
It's impacted the development of games, including replaced from Sad Cat Studios, a Belarusian studio with devs from Belarus and Ukraine. The team had long hoped to reveal a new trailer here today, but were understandably unable to complete it in time. Guys, I just want to say we're thinking of you and all the developers impacted by the conflict. We hope to be able to share your work at a future show.
To mě, right,
our next game is an
official
selection of the Tribeca Games Festival. It's American Arcadia, where you play Trevor, whose life is being televised, with the viewing population constantly voting you up or down. When you become unpopular, you need to start running for your life. Check this out.
Ty vole, Truman Show, IRL.
Hail to the king, baby.
Picture a city where technology and science go hand in hand with fun and entertainment.
My grandfather, Elijah Walton, had a dream to build the city of tomorrow. That dream is now a reality.
Teď 1984, the video game.
Arcadia. A 43-square-mile metropolis where each and every citizen enjoys a life of luxury and comfort. Broadcast live 24 hours a day, 7 days a week on every digital platform.
Tak aby vypadala naše republika, kdyby jsme vystěhovali moje sousedy.
Control. Subject on the run on camera 4.
Jo, ale jo, jenom říkám.
Interrupt broadcast immediately.
Listen to me. We can't allow Trevor Hills to escape under any circumstances. Trevor.
Jak se jmenovala hra, kde jsi taky utíkal z té utopie, která byla udržovaná pomocí toho, jestli furt bral ty prášky. Co to jmenovalo? To bylo toho We Happy Few, ne? I'm going to get you out of there. Jich tam byly ty konstáblové s těma ksichtama, s těma maskama. Jo, to vypadá docela dobře. Jestli bych si zahrál.
Apparently we've made it to the beach.
Geoff je na pláži, holy moly, to je ta pláž z GTAčka, chat.
There's trouble in paradise and watch out.
O půlnoci je Devolver konference, no tam bylo tvoje máme 3.
With the game and I know you have TennoCon coming up in July, which is your big kind of event of the year to reveal what's next. What can you tell us?
Well, I can't tell too much, but yeah, July 16th, 2022, it's a digital event again this year. Today, actually, we just launched the digital items for it, so you can get some in-game goodies, some really cool cosmetics, some merch, all that really great stuff went live today. But of course, the reason I'm here is to, you know, kind of debut. We have our
Wolverframe NFT,
which is our big reveal of the night. And we usually do a little bit of a gameplay, a little bit of a demo.
Zlobření.
I think a lot of people can suspect what it might be, but I'm here to kind of confirm.
Jo, bude, já chci rád, co se rozpekla, mě to bavilo včera.
And what is that?
Can I say it?
Yes, I think you can.
Okay, you're going to get your first look at the Deviri paradox.
It's finally.
Finally, I know it's been a couple of years.
Hele, až bude konec prezentace, tak Top Donator rozhoduje, jakou hru jdeme hrát, jestli jdeme na to demo nebo jdeme na souseda.
On the teaser you're about to see, and I'm just really proud and excited to show it.
Awesome. Well, thanks so much for being here on Summer Game Fest. Let's take a look at that right now.
My child, my friend. What was done is done. New dangers. New choices await us now.
Tenno Live klasicky, dostaneš free Prime bundle. Neremastrovaná 2009 hra POG. Děláš si prdel, Warframe běží na CryEngineu, ne? Ten vypadá graficky za prvý dost dobře a za druhý je doslova zadáčo celou tu dobu. Nemno, jako Trištelkár Warframe, můžou jenom lidi, co nikdy nehráli Warframe, mimo. A to jsem ho hrál chvíli.
And this new trailer reveals, for the very first time, a new and exotic realm players will be able to explore.
Ah, kurva.
Listen.
Kolik je těm holkám? Chci vidět věk, chci vidět občanky každého protagonisty téhle hry. Dobrý, jedna z nich vypadala, ta blond vypadala dospělá, tak je to v pohodě.
You know in your heart where you're heading, you will arrive at the end of the story.
Ona prostě pije čajík, zatímco tam snipe nebo se nuclear strike.
That's the you I like.
Ona to je aj Sukuba ještě k tomu. Takže to je taková Monika týhle videohry. Proč se to studio jmenuje Hoňkaj? Proč se studio jmenuje Hoňkaj a dělá takovýhle videohry? Jo, what the f***? Ne, to není studio ani, tak se jmenuje ta hra se jmenuje Hoňkaj, kde podle loru jim pravděpodobně všem je 2000 let. No nic, tak to, OK. Asiati zašli až příliš daleko.
I have to say I'm blown away by what I've seen so far. It was announced a couple weeks ago and it has the detail of Genshin Impact with a fast-paced action style. Here is the world premiere of a brand new look at Zenless's notable characters, armed enemies and world of danger.
Tohle bylo v Bingu, já už jsem na to Bingo zapomněl. Ach kurva, tohle bude ještě horší, vidím, že jedna z nich má kočičí uši. Já nechci. I don't wanna!
Thank you.
Zcela jistě se nezaměřili s fyzikou na konkrétní místa. Tam je Fury postava a k tomu náctiletý prostě holky v uniformách. Jo, to mě poser. Tohle je špatný, če, tohle je špatný. Konečně kvalitní hra, pomer!
Arcade games back in the day. Well, it's nearing the end of development, and the team wanted to use SGF as a way to reveal one exciting aspect of the game they've been keeping under wraps until now.
Kde je ta snělka k původní? Ty píčo, je tam AKC? Go odpálil. Šest hráčů mod, jsi až prdel, ne? Ty vole, to se jako jak vyznáš na té obrazovce. Šest nemám ani kamarádů, který bych dal dohromady za celý život. Už tam jede na tom Gameboyovi. Počkej, to je za týden. Mobilní, ty vole, hry reklamy na mobilní hry. Byl už Quarry, který je zítra. Už přichází pátek do Titanu. Bude tam i kód MV2? Jo, bude určitě na konci. Super lidé, finální beta. To je Womankind ještě furt nevyšlo, no. No počkej, vyšlo? Ne, vlastně vyšlo, já jsem to akorát nehrál. Inkové. Kubánci, ty vole. Můžeš tam prožít Lukášovu dovolenou. Latinská Amerika. Come to Brazil! Ale počkat, je zde více. Super Ancient Tribes. In the Hall of the Mountain King. Tohle je ten cápek ze Stranger Things, kdyby byl ženská. How far will you push humankind? Počkej, až budou v Humankind do Češi. Ne, asi kdy tam dají husy ty jako v Age of Empires do píče.
One Piece is celebrating its 25th anniversary this year, and Bandai Namco is bringing the mega popular franchise back to video games with One Piece Odyssey. Monkey D. Luffy and his crew of pirates are off on their next adventure. This trailer reveals the setting, a mysterious island where Luffy and his Straw Hat crew become marooned in this exciting upcoming JRPG.
The Straw Hat Pirates journeying along the Grand Line.
Chat, já stále nechápu, že ten seriál jmenuje One Piece, když definitivně to není jenom jeden díl, podle mě jich je trochu víc.
A
jako líbí se mi, že ty based východní developeři azijský, tak tam všichni mají oblečení, jenom prostě ženská s největšíma kozama je komplet v plavkách, protože prostě může být. Škoda, že ty plavky nejsou jednodílný, chápeš? Já to pochopil. Unravel the adventure that awaits. In an odyssey beyond imagination. One Piece Odyssey. V jednodílných plavkách už jsem prostě nemožná.
Kokova. Anata tachi no kyoku o moto ni tsukurareta sekai yo.
Shut the fuck up.
Hail to the king, baby.
This August, Soul Hackers 2 from Atlus launches, and we've got your first listen to the English voice cast with this quick new look.
Při Uvalde School shootingu v Texasu trvalo policie.
Čet, teď bude určitě nějaká západní videohra zase. Shirley shi... Bruh, why you do me like this? Bude, proč první hodina byly jako všechno západní hry a teďko si tohle to nechali prostě tady. Aby to tady nasázeli na mojí palici. One more chance to make things right.
So that's our mission then, save the world.
With so many new games featured across SGF events, you might be wondering how to plan for your summer gaming dreams. NerdWallet can help you find the smartest credit card to reward your gaming purchases at nerdwallet.com.
The Epic Mega Sale is going on right now. Save up to 75% off top PC titles with an additional 25% off eligible products.
Holy.
And it wouldn't be the Mega Sale without the free games
vault. Chat, this is going to be
featuring Maneater.
Be sure to claim your copy before the sale ends on June 16th.
Tune into the Epic Games Store. Twitch channel for a summer showcase on June 10th at 2 p.m. Eastern, 11 a.m. Pacific. We're taking a look at new announcements and updates from PC titles heading to the store this year and beyond.
Hail to the king.
Support the creator nemáš na Steamu? Nemá nikdo. Navíc ty slevy jsou na Epicu.
You nuts.
Samsung Gaming Hub.
Hail
má umět ta nová Samsung chytrá televize, ne? Že hraješ i na Xboxové hry bez Xboxu. To je ono, že jo? Takže to je přes to, přes cloudový gaming a ty nemusíš mít ani tu konzoli. Ty máš prostě jenom tu televizi. Dneska to spustili, no. Ty máš prostě tu televizi, ani to nepotřebuješ stáhnout. Máš televizi, Wi-Fi a hraješ Game Pass bez Xboxu. Jako, já furt věřím kabelům a hardwareu. Každopádně do budoucna velice zajímavá záležitost. Co jsou tohle Early Daft Punk? Ty pičo, konečně Mario. Kdy bude Mario Odyssey 2? To je ten fotbálek, co teďko vychází, zítra to vychází, že jo? No tohle vypadá mega zábavně, tohle co jsem si říkal, že bych dal proti Melikarovi, kdyby ten idiot měl Switch, nebo byl ochotný ho koupit pro content. Tohle je FIFA, ale zábavná, prez tam můžete bušit. Mario Strikers Battle League. Only on Nintendo Switch. Game rated everyone 10 and up. Tak můj klub, če děláte ze mě prdel?
Hi, my name is Carl and I'm a developer on Metal Hellsinger. You know how in some games where the music's really good, you feel compelled to move and shoot to the beat? But what if you had to? In Metal, the better you are at slaying to the beat, the more intense everything.
Tuhle hru jsem zkoušel a vůbec mi to nešlo.
Legendary artists like Serge Tankian from System of a Down. So while headbanging isn't mandatory, we do recommend it. Our demo is live now on Steam, Xbox and PlayStation platforms.
Tady z té hry jsem zjistil, že nemám absolutně žádný smysl pro rytmus. Neplatíš si to z bullets per minute, to není to samý. Limo guide. Koko, vole, si jste opět dám, bratře. Serge tam dorazil. Bullets per minute je mnohem horší verze tohohle v každém aspektu. Aha, no tak já jsem hrál to Bullets per minute a to mi vůbec nešlo. Tak mohu zkusit tohle z toho, jestli to je lepší. Jako demo vyšlo a 15. celá hra, ale tak jako může to zkusit, no.
That one was Metal Hellsinger coming later this year from Funcom, a rhythm shooter with metal music.
Za ním.
And right now, as I mentioned, a demo has launched on PC, Xbox and PlayStation for you to play for free.
A kde jakože bola ta hudba
next
v té hře?
Next up,
a new game launches tomorrow. Co si dají dajím stáč? Oh my god, nedělní Imagine Dragons byli out of this world, moje bestie. A pak kdyby si vzal ty vole, kdyby si prostě vzal na Brutal Assault, tak se tam rozbreče ještě u brány. Here's the first look
at the launch trailer. Family is the most important thing in the world.
Tete dreamy, ty vole. Čet, počkej moment, tohle mi připomíná jako nějaká hra.
If your whole family,
to se mi připomíná nějakou hru.
Like every last one of them decided to jump down the bottom of a well, and all just hanging on the end of a rope. How can one person be expected to pull them all back out? You can't. So you pull on that rope and you're just gonna fall right down to the bottom of the well with the rest of them. And what's the point of that?
What?
Už zítra, tere.
Kidnapping, murder, cover-ups. I think the whole Hackett family is in on it.
You have no idea what's going on.
Ty vole, Android Bishop zvedčel zvuk, ale legenda. Hromada nadržených náctiletých. Koupání v noci. Doly. Rodina redneků.
Goodbye, cruel world. We gotta get out.
I'm gonna enjoy watching you die.
Tohle je to na mácháči. To, tohle točil ten řezník na mácháči. This is gonna get a little messy. Jako dobrá hudba, ty vole. Dobrá hudbička. To je to, to je, když si báječný chlap najde báječnou ženskou. A shared world survival crafting game from Inflection Games up in Canada. Now it's time to give you a brand new look and deeper look at the game, including its innovative realm card system that lets you impact things like the weather pattern, resources, and challenges in this procedural realms. Here is your exclusive new look. Tenhle trailer ukázal nejméně nebezpečný let na mácháči. You're alone in the realms, I'm afraid. The portals are a mess. Not even sure if Nightingale made it. Given how fragile. Já se těším na zítra, jako ty recenze překvapivě. Já jsem se bál, že to bude mít nižší recenze, jako třeba to. Jako třeba třetí jurský svět. Ale má to 80%, ty vole, takže jako těším se, no. Já doufám, že to prostě bude na styl toho Until Dawn a že to pofrčí. Ještě uvidíme, jestli to bude hrát na PC nebo na PS5, protože klíč budu mít na PCčko, takže stop, snad by to mělo být v pohodě. Každopádně to, a má to recenze jak Mario Strikers, ty vole. Void, waiting to get in. Co to je, ty vole? To mě nemá na hlavě. Klecek z Bloodborne. No jo. Důlovit obří game, to je vlhkej sen každého Američana. Kurva, abych dal cokoliv, aby tohle Force nainstaloval a zapnul ty vole ten, zapnul voice chat a bojové by tam napadnuli čínský server. A Číňani by pak prostě vyvěsili vlajku No Forsen a to přeškrtnutý Forsen E. Demo across PC and console, which lets you design and set up your character. And since it's Saints Row, you guys are gonna have a lot of fun with this one. Check it out. Už odložili to Saints Row nebo ne?
Guys,
you gotta do something to capture people's attention. So what do we build next?
Me. I want all the power. Tady nebude rapovej soundtrack, to se k týhle hře nehodí zcela jistě. OMG, viděl jsem Balch. To je to cyberpunkery, no.
Seriously, this is perfect.
Dinner and a show, baby.
Tak kvůli tomuhle Spike schodil RP server na 2 dny. Já vás nenávidím. Ty vole, Pavel, vsadím si, že Pavel, když čumí na tenhle trailer, tak úplně... Oho, představ si, až tam někdo dá roleplay mod. Míša mě po svatbě už nikdy neuvidí. Bemerž dřív pro subs. Vzhledem k tomu, že není limitovaný na kusy, tak nemusí být, takže zítra to normálně vychází všechno. A je 9 dní. Na objednávku, takže pohoda.
Next, we've got an exclusive first look at extended gameplay of Warhammer 40K Darktide, Fat Shark's follow-up to the critically acclaimed Vermintide series. Darktide promises intense four-player co-op action and it's out on September 13th for PC, on Steam, and exclusively on console.
Další roleplay hra v následě dalších 100k pro Pavla. Dobré chat, hele jo, můžete přestat milkovat vtip, který tady vyloženě ty vole byl po týdnu, to je vykokotí.
Manufacturer makes L7836 is heading towards a power systems failure thanks to a bit of heretic sabotage.
So you're going to restore
the coolant and hopefully save the day. Get in, access the operations array and use the cryonic rods to flush the system. Preferably before something explodes. Head on through the ventilation tunnels and look for an access point.
This way! Move it!
Set your dates for interrogators. If all goes well, we can unlock the system, prime the rods, and send them where they're needed. That's the first part done. Get to the base of the Matrix bar and put those cryonic rods to work.
Ty vole, Vermintide 2 měla vlastně to, že když to hrál v koopu, tak tam byl Twitch chat integrace. Že hlasoval Twitch chat. Dokedy se to bude pozerať? Hele, bude to obrovský šokr, ale do té doby ještě skončí. Já vím, to si se nedalo očekávat, ale já rád dělám takovýhle nepopulární volby.
Bloober team is known for psychological horror games like Blair Witch and The Medium.
Nah.
Today, they are ready to reveal their latest creation made completely in Unreal Engine 5 for a visceral horror experience. It's a return to the world of Layers of Fears. Get a dose of this.
Fact? Layers of Fear? Best soft reboot? Someone said insanity runs in our family. Not a little bit, huh?
Let it run.
Jako reálně Layers of Fear 1 byla snad jediná jejich dobrá hra. Dvojka teda už pak jako mě úplně minula tím jejich tvůrčím záměrem. Ne, oni ještě dělali vlastně Observera, tak ten byl lepší. Observer byl jejich pík za mě, ten se mi líbil.
And guilt of an artist trapped in a place beyond redemption. It's a lie. This is a story of my fear, pain, and hatred, of the horror of my loneliness. And it is mine to tell.
Now I see it. All this misery, all this suffering. There was no other way.
Shouldn't have. You really shouldn't have.
An empty shell cannot live forever.
There's a wiki dole.
Trapped in this house, bound by this body.
To je takový jako soft reboot, no, tam jsou scény z jedničky a dvojky, ale zároveň to je jako
full nová hra. This October, Gotham Knights arrives.
Oh shit, Gotham hrál od tvůrců nejslabšího dílu z Arkham série. Bylo tam už něco o GOF? Jo. Ty největší Sony exkluzivky si nenechávají na Sony konference, ty si nechávají na Summer Game Fest speciálně.
Hello and warm welcome from WB Games Montreal. I'm Fleur Marty. I'm the executive producer on Gotham Knights.
Na konci bude ještě
today,
ten Last of Us remake.
Today, we are thrilled to share more with you on one of our beloved knights, Nightwing. This showcase is the first in our character series, and we're really looking forward to share more
Asylum.
With you as we continue working towards our launch on October 25th. So, I hope you enjoy the show and stay tuned.
To víš jak? Čet, netrapušte se s tím Garovorem. Víte, že o tom nemůžu mluvit, kurva. Stalker 2 už tam byl. Jo, protože developeři Stalker 2. Oni doslova 3 měsíce zpátky utekli z Ukrajiny z rozbombardovaných baráků a první, co je napadlo, ty vole, ale co když zklamu gamery na Twitchi a nestihneme tu konferenci. To bylo vyloženě první, co prostě zařídili, jakmile ty vole utekli a zkontrolovali, že všichni z rodiny jsou v pohodě. Dělat na Devolver o půlnoci, tve, já bych si Devolver v konferenci nenechal ujít.
I got this, Bruce.
Já nevím, no, jako moc tomu nevěřím, ale zahraju si to.
That was Gotham Knights, and now we welcome... Oh, look who it is. Neil Druckmann from Naughty Dog, co-president of Naughty Dog. Great to have you with us, Neil. It's been an eventful day on the internet for Naughty Dog fans. And
Prosím.
I think we jinxed ourselves. We were joking about last night, like, watch the
Neil, don't you do this. Neil, prosím.
The good news is there's some stuff that hasn't leaked that we have lots to share with people about all things at Naughty Dog. But first of all, it is it's a big month actually for Last of Us fans because Last of Us 1 and 2 both launched in June and it's nearing its 2-year anniversary for Last of Us.
Ano, už to jsou 2 roky od Last of Us 2, čet.
Yeah, it's crazy. 9 years for Last of Us 1, 2 years for Last of Us Part 2, and we still hear from fans. They're still sending us letters and art, and these characters in this world mean so much to them.
Já si myslím, že jako ano. I po těch 2 letech mu fakt furt něco posílají, ale v těch dopisech, ty vole, si myslím, že něco jiného, než si myslíš, že tam je.
And that kind of support, that kind of success, we're so grateful to our fans. It has allowed us to grow as a studio, and now we can take on multiple projects. And that kind of support, that kind of success, we're so grateful to our fans. It has allowed us to grow as a studio, and now we can take on multiple projects more than we've ever had at the same time.
Multiple projects. Okay, very interesting. So, what can Last of Us fans expect in the future from you?
Thank you for asking, Jeff. Yes. So, one of the things we've mentioned a while back is what started out as a multiplayer mode has evolved due to the team's ambition. They really wanted to do something beyond what we've ever done before at Naughty Dog, and we felt the way to do it justice is to make it a standalone title. And over they've been working on it for the past 2 years.
Samostatný Last of Us
mode,
jak paráda.
We're not fully unveil it, but we're ready to lift the curtain a little bit and just give you like an update of where we're at.
Okay, well, what can you tell us about this new standalone multiplayer game?
Yeah, so we have a concept art that we want to show. Yeah. But what I can tell you there, is that this game is big.
Okay.
It's as big as any of our single player games that we've done, and in some ways bigger.
This game is big, and it keeps getting bigger. That's because Jesus Christ.
This game, it's got a brand new cast of characters. It takes place at another place, another part of the United States.
It's like a city might be somewhat familiar to some people.
I'm sure our fans have already figured it out. It's really cool, and it's being headed by Vinith Agarwal, Anthony Newman, and Joe Padmany.
Last of Us 76.
All veterans of Uncharted. And you're going to see a lot more of this game.
Tak to je ovšem velice ambiciozní Níle. Na tom pohořeli i mistři šachového klubu.
This has evolved and I mean that concept art looks incredible. I can't wait to see Naughty Dog storytelling fused with multiplayer live game.
It's something special. We can't wait to show it either.
Ty vole, představ si, že tam dají všechny charaktery do toho mulťáku a bude tam Ice King Joela, ale budeš mít melee zbraň na blízko, pálku, to má prostě tu golfovou hůl.
Last of Us show for HBO, right?
Yeah, so for the past year, you know, we've teamed up with Craig Mazin of Chernobyl fame and HBO to adapt The Last of Us into a TV TV show.
No, jo, já úplně zapomněl, že bude ten seriál ještě.
It's pretty incredible. The stuff I'm getting back, when we're looking at back at Naughty Dog, we can't help but feel emotional because not only is it so good and the quality is so high, it's so authentic to what we've made in the game. I just can't, I couldn't be
zase na druhou stranu like HBO, Craig, Pedro Pascal a Černobyl, ty borci.
Their last day of filming is tomorrow.
So the entire series, last day of filming is
last
tomorrow.
Last day of filming is tomorrow. Craig is up there right now, kind of wrapping it all up. So it's pretty close. It's closer than you might think.
Další raz nejvíc mediocre combat systémem v AAA průmyslu, nemohu se dočkat. Jako u jedničky bys toho asi souhlasil, ale Last of Us 2 měla dle mě jako zábavný combat systém. Ta mě fakt bavila. Hlavně v té druhé půlce.
This is a certain museum that players might know from the game. And I really have to talk about Pedro Pascal and Bella Ramsey and not only directing them, but seeing them do all the other episodes, they've thrown themselves at these roles for a whole year. Watching the nuance that they bring to these characters, their relationship on and off camera, I couldn't help but think about Troy Baker and Ashley Johnson. It felt so similar to the chemistry those two actors had when we made the game. And it really feels like this is going to be something special. And I will say this will be the most authentic video game adaptation yet.
Well, I mean, that first image that they put out, it just, I mean, it feels like the video game. Everything that I've seen, both public and other stuff, makes it feel sort of super legitimate, as you said, and that's awesome to see Joel and Ellie from the front side now for the first time. So we'll see more of that next year that's coming as well, right, Sirius?
Eliana Mormont. Jo, tam měla hrát Ellie, no.
All right, well, Last of Us HBO, very, very exciting. And I hear you actually have a couple actors from the show who are going
to
join us here.
We happen to have a couple actors here that are part of the show. We should bring them up.
Teď přijde znova Troy Baker. Ne, asi když už ho tam mají, tak samozřejmě, že přijde.
Surprise. Vole. Troy's back again. Hello, Ashley. Good
to see you. Good to see you.
I'm a little confused, though. I thought maybe Pedro Bella, but Troy Ashley out here from the game, right?
So when Craig and I started working on the show, almost one of our very first meetings, we said, Troy and Ashley have to be a part of it. And we're such fans of, like, the talent and the like helping us create Joel and Ellie, we felt like it was so important that they become part of the show. And it wasn't, it has to be more than just like kind of like a wink to the camera and like a cameo. Okay. These are real roles that we're keeping under wraps for now. But man, I'm bummed that I couldn't be there with you guys when you filmed your stuff.
There's been so much
it's
stuff
so,
I feel like.
So good.
On the internet, there's so much like talk about what's being filmed. And I think that's, you guys have kept a complete secret that you, so you were up there and you filmed your roles by now, obviously.
Keeping secrets with this franchise is kind of old hat. Like we've
except
had.
Except for today.
Except for the date. It was one of the hardest things for us to do.
Burka je to by ve hře o přežití nemohla být, protože tam je nedostatek jídla XD. Tady někdo nehrál Last of Us 2, kde Abby má bicáky jako Tyler Mann, protože je schopná žrát 200 gramů bílkovin denně během zombie apokalypsy.
Is such a fan of this game, and they all knew what it was that they were working on and committed to working on this project because of their fan and their love for the game.
Hail to the king, baby.
Was one of the greatest. It was like I was coming home to friends.
Yeah,
Troy Baker přišel prodat svoje NFTčka a on je nakonec nevydal, ne? Oni ho zhejtili na Twitteru a on od toho odešel od toho projektu ještě než to vůbec začalo.
Perfect, and we've been trying to sort of describe that feeling of sort of seeing them in person.
Seriál bude podle první série, nebo to bude mít vlastní děj?
It's like the characters coming to life, but it's so much more than that. I feel like I can't fully explain it, but I am so excited to be a part of it, and just I can't wait to see it. I think it is going to be so good.
Se, ne, myslím, že to bude předělávka
těch her. I love the story. I love just being a part of
it. I'm so excited about the series and the fact that you guys are going to be in it and undisclosed roles. I'm so fascinated how it's going to sort of bob and weave and you know, are these characters we know from the game that they're playing new characters? Can you tell us anything?
Yes.
I can tell you.
So sneaky.
Jako on na začátku říkal, že to, on tam na začátku říkal, že to má být velice věrný té videohře. Actually snad použil slovo nejvěrnější adaptace. Otázka je, jako, jak si to vyložíš.
Remaking the original game, and this is like a ground-up remake, is that right?
That's right. We wanted to give people the definitive version of the first game that wasn't included by any technology.
Třetí definitivní edice Last of Us jedničky, já se nemohu dočkat.
And we're able to do it on the PS5.
Ty byl Last of Us jednička reálně, začíná dohánět Skyrim v těch verzích. To už je fakt poslední verze Skyrimu, moji hoši. Tak ukáž, ty chci vidět ten gigantický skok v té grafice.
So why did you leave Boston?
Been on quite the adventure, little brother.
Jako je to celý remake, ne remaster, by to mělo vypadat fakt jako pohodně jinak.
He's got everything to do with that little girl.
You know, I've never been this close. It's the outside.
So is that everything you hoped for?
Can't be any worse out there. Can it?
Once upon a time, I had somebody that I cared about.
But on my list, this world is good for one
thing. Get you killed.
I can take care of myself.
How many close calls have we had?
I get into trouble down there. You make every shot count.
I got this.
You know how to use that thing.
I've had some practice.
A jako jo, vypadá to dobře s tou Last of Us 2 grafikou, ale ten skok tam není zase tak šílený.
Truly one of my favorite games of the past decade. Guys, what's your reaction?
Co je jako velká, co je velká rána do ksichtu. Je, že prostě ty vole remakeovat se mají hry, které jsou třeba 15 let starý, protože tam to fakt jako prokoukne. Taky to vyjde, jako nevyjde to ve stejný den na PC, protože to teprve vyvíjí na to PC. No a hlavně, ta nejlepší část nakonec, za ten remake, těch 70 euro. Jedou podle té nový triple A ceny jako kotko a ten remake bude stát 70 Eček.
They're closer to the original performance. All the animators went and
studied those videos and got closer to what you did on set. To je 1800 korun za ten remake.
And that's just like one of the things we could talk about, like this brand new AI, like all the combat is redone. The fidelity of everything, 60 frames per second, all the stuff you're getting on the PS5. Again, we wanted to give, knowing because of the show, because this, they're all new players for PS5 and PC.
Už je líklo, že v té base hře není to Left Behind DLC a bude ve Firefly edici za 100 euro.
I actually played it.
Já jsem viděl tu Firefly edici. To je krabička se Steelbookem a s tím DLC, který je na 2 hodiny a jediný se tam zajímavý je, že Ellie je lesba.
I was just a glutton for punishment. I went straight from playing part 1 straight into part 2.
Takže remake remasteru z roku 2014. Ani ne 10 let.
I can't wait to go back because it was you guys did such an amazing job on that original game and
dohromady za 2500 korun.
Imagine that, you know, think of the last combat, but kind of that back in the Last of Us
World. Fake to DLC bude v základu. No jako zatím to je z těch líků, nebo respektive oni to jako uveřejnili dneska odpoledne a pak to zase stáhnuli, protože čekali předpokládám na tadyhle ten, jako to, tadyhle ten reveal. A lepší mi fakt jako píčovi nadávat tak krátký DLC do dražší edice. To snad bude v základu, ne?
We will look forward to it. Neil, you've talked a lot about games directed by other people. What are you directing? You still making games?
Still making games. Okay. I haven't given up my day job. It's a little early to talk about it. Maybe if someone in PlayStation wants to leak it, then we can talk about it now. Otherwise, we'll save
it. But you do have a new project.
Do have a new project, okay. But we'll save it for another Summer Game Fest.
Okay. Okay, well, we'll see. We'll try and save it. All right. Troy, Ashley, Neil, thank you so much for dropping by Summer Game Fest, and I am so excited that The Last of Us is returning, as you said, in September. So thanks, guys. Appreciate awesome. It.
Thanks, Jeff.
Awesome. All right, well, that is going to do it. Thanks to Naughty Dog and PlayStation for that very special look at The Last of Us and the entire franchise and where things are going. Very, very excited about that. All right, Summer Game Fest continues over the next few days.
Jaj, poslední hra, ty vole, prostě. Poslední hra. At the planet Atlanta. Je remake za 70
Tomorrow we've got Netflix Geeked Week, which
I'll be kurva Walking Dead Mission 2, no to jsem taky čekal.
Along with the Epic Games Store Showcase. And then finally Sunday, it's the Xbox and Bethesda Game Showcase. You can stream them all at summergamefest.com. As for me, I'll see you again in August when we are back live.
Jako v neděli, to musí být fakt bomba, bratře. Potom co Microsoft koupil asi tak jako všechny studia, tak v neděli kurva čekám, ty vole, minimálně 10 AAA her.
As a digital and in-person event to bring the gaming community together. Thanks for being a part of Summer Game Fest, and remember, there are more events and announcements to come. We'll see you soon.
V neděli čekám Wolfenstein 3, Dishonored 3, Kingdom Come 2, dneska o půlnoci Hotline Miami 3, ano, jsem nejméně naivní muž.
Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Day of the Devs!
Star Wars Jedi Survivor gameplay won't be, although it will sound nice.
Day of the Devs is the greatest and definitely the oldest independent games festival that exists. It was started over 10 years ago by Double Fine Productions and I am 8-Bit to celebrate the best independent games out there and bring them to you, the fans. We wanted to bring developers and players together to get together, play games, and have a great time. It used to be a physical event only in San Francisco, but now it has gone digital so the whole world can enjoy it. And we're really excited this year to be part of Summer Game Fest. So sit back, relax, put on your party hats.
Check was not really Dead Island 2. Kámo, ten Dead Island.
Your party hats. Everybody.
Ten Dead Island. Ty píčo, no to byla jaká kudla, more.
That looks good.
Ty vole.
Put on your party hat and enjoy.
Regulérně takhle jsem už mega dlouho nebyl vymrdaný. Takhle dlouho jsem už fakt nebyl vymrdaný. Přijde ta konference, fakt na píču. ČC Gaming je na píču, druhá GTA RP. Já už se netěším ani na ten God of War Ragnarok. Netěším se už na nic. Všechny hry stojí za ovno, gaming je mrtvej. Stejně na to nemám prachy, všichni jste lúzeři. Chodit ven a zažívat actual zážitky s reálnýma lidma je mnohem lepší. To je konec, poslední rok mojí kariéry. 2023, už nebudu streamovat. Later bitches, gaming je mrtvej, odcházím.